እግዚአብሔር መስገን ኩልና ጸሎት መንፈስ ነው።
Okay, let's begin. Please bow your heads in prayer.
እግዚአብሔር አምላክ ሽንካይ እስኪ ኩልና በመንፈስ ጸሎት ቆይና እግዚአብሔር ገለ ነገር ከዛረበና አቅርም ይሆን ቀርብና ንሱ ተተዛሪቡ ጥራሕዩ ልቢ ዝትንከፍ ልቢ ዝርታዕ ዝተሰብረ ዝፅገን ዝተባላሸወ ዝዕረ ፎሲን ስልጣንን ኩሉ ኣብ ቃሉ ኣሎ እግዚኣብሔር መስገን እግዚኣብሔር እስኪ ንውሽጥና ገለ ክዛረበና ኣብ ቅድሚ ይነቕረብ
Okay, let's go before the Lord so that he can speak to our hearts today.
ጎይታ ኢየሱስ ክርስቶስ በሰዓት ዝብየስ ክብሪ ይበካለኹ እስኻ እሙኒኻ እግዚአብሔር ኣብ ሰማይ ኮነ ኣብ ምድሪ ኣብ ዘበን ኩሉ ከማኻ ዝበለ ኣምላኽ የለን እግዚአብሔር ኣቦየ ሽምካ ንጽዋዕ ኣለና ኣብዚ ምችኡን ጥጥሑን ቦታ ኮይና ነቲ ዓብይን ግኑንን ስምካ ክብሪ ንህብ ኣሎና እግዚኣብሔር ምሕረትካ ኣባና ካባና ስለዘይተፈለየስ እግዚኣብሔር ኣብ ፀፅባሕ ንስኻ ምሳና ኣለኻ እግዚኣብሔር ኣብ ምድሪ ስደት እግዚኣብሔር ከምዚ በለ ናይ ኣምልኾ ግዜን ቦታን ስለ ዝሃብካና ክብሪ ንበካ ኣሎና እግዚኣብሔር ኣምላኸየ ከምዚ ኢልና ምስ ደቅና ሓቢርና ቋንቋን ቦታን ከይፈለየና እግዚኣብሔር ከምዚ ኢልና በዚ ንጎዚ ስምካ ክንፅውዕ ስለ ዝፈተኻ እግዚኣብሔር ሽምካ ይበካ ክብ የብሎ ኣሎ ሎሚ ኩነታትና ኣብ ዘለዎ ከሎ ክብሪ ንበካ ኣሎና እግዚኣብሔር ብዝወረደና ኩሉ ንስኻ ጻድቕ ኢኻ እግዚኣብሔር ብናሓልፎ ኩሉ ንስኻ ጻድቕ ኢኻ እግዚኣብሔር ኣብ ዘበን ኩሉ እግዚኣብሔር ንስኻ እሙን ኢኻ ክብሪ ይበካ ኣሎ እንተበርታዕና እንተደኸምና እንተሓመምና እንተተሓለልና ንስኻ ጻድቕ ኢኻ እግዚኣብሔር ከም ቀደምካ ኢኻ እግዚአብሔር ኣብ ዘበን ኩሉ ንስኻ ፈጺምካ ኣይትስልክን ያ ክብሪ ንበካ ኣሎና ስለ ምሕረትካ እግዚአብሔር ክብሪ ንበካ ኣሎና ስለ ፍቕርኻ እግዚአብሔር ክብሪ ንበካ ኣሎና ስለ ተሓያሊድካ እግዚአብሔር ክብሪ ንበካ ኣሎና ኣብ ዘበን ኩሉ ሽምካ ይኽበር እግዚአብሔር ኣምላኽ ስለ ሓወይ በረኸት ይጽልይ ኣለኹ ንስኻ እግዚአብሔር ኣምላኽ ምስትውዓል ክትበው ይጽልይ ኣለኹ ንህዝብኻ ክዛረብ ክኽእል ስለ ገዛ ርእሰይ ይጽልይ ኣለኹ እግዚኣብሔር ሒዜ ዝመጻኹ ኩሉ ንዓኻ ይበካ ኣለኹ ንስኻ ክትዛረብ እግዚኣብሔር ናተይ ዘበለ ዋጋ ይብሉን እሞ እግዚኣብሔር ንመንፈስካ እግዚኣብሔር ኣሕሊፈ ኣብ ጉባኤና ይቦ ኣለኹ እግዚኣብሔር ኣምላኽ ልቢ ዝጉባኤ እዚ ከተዳሉ ንዓበይትን መንእስያትን እግዚኣብሔር ንስኻ ክትዛረቦም ይጽልይ ኣለኹ ጎይታ የሱስ ኩሉ ክብሪ ኩሉ ኣምልኾ ኩሉ ስግደት ንዓኻ ይኹን አሜን ከመይ ቀኒኹም ብድጋሚ
how is everyone
ምስ በረኸት ሓወይ ኮይና ሎ ማዓንቲ ገለ ቃል እግዚአብሔር ከነካፍለኩም ኢና
me and Johnny are going to share the words of God with you today
ስለዚ ፍቓድኩም እንተዳ ኮይኑ ኩላትኩም ኣብ መጽሐፍ መሳፍንቲ ሻምናይ ምዕራፍ ክትከፍቱ ብትሕትና ክሓተኩም እየ
Okay, please turn to the book of Judges, chapter 8, for this morning.
Kab kutri 22 kisa 27 zolo kana nibibina katsilnaun kab 33 siga 35 zolo kana nibibina ma hawai barakat ka bi ingilizi nyak dogmoy.
We're going to read the chapter 8 of Judges, verses 22 to 27, and then we're going to skip down to verse 33 to 35 as well.
شعو سب إسرائيل نقدون كبيت ميديان أدحين كان يخمو نسخا ودخان ودخان قزونا بلو قدون كا أنس أيقزا كومن وديون أيقزا كومن إكزيابير دا يقزا كوم بلو إكزيابير دا يقزا كوم بلو قدون دما كواهاتكم قدا حدا لمانو لمن اللهو نفس وكف نتي زمارخو ألابتي هابوني بلوم نساتهم إسماعيل ما عيوانن نبرو ما سلزي ألابتي ورقي نبروم نساتهم كات حقشنا نبكا بلو كدان دما زرقحو نفس وكف كا اتي زمارخو ألابتي ناوو دربيو بجي كاتي أبنقستات مديانون زنبرة درين كتشان جمجا كداونتن بجاكا اتي ابك سعودي اغمالوم زنبره دقواتت اتي زلمونو قلابت ورقي ميزانو شحن 700 سيقال ورقي كونه غيدون دمانو افورت غيرو ابكتمو اب افرون امبرو بزلو اسرائيل كا ددحريو ابو زمو إذا نجديون نبيتون مفنترا خونة إذا نجديون نبيتون مفنترا خونة كونا دماء جديون مش موتا دك إسرائيل تمليسهم ددحري بعليم زمو نبعال بريث أملاخهم قبروا وترسالة سنة أربعة دك إسرائيل نتي خبيد إتم أبزريهم زنبرو خلهم سلاتهم زدحانهم إكزيابير أملاخهم أيزكروون نبيت يربعال مالت جديون كم تنسون إسرائيل زغبر اللهم كلو تصبو نغرسي غلامو ياكوا أي غبرو دون غلامو ياكوا أي غبرو دون.
We're going to start at verse 22, if you read along with me please. The Israelites said to Gideon, "Rule over us, you and your son and your grandson, because you have saved us from the hand of the Midian." But Gideon told them, "I will not rule over you, nor will my son rule over you. The Lord will rule over you." And he said, I do have one request, that each of you give me an earring from the share of the plunder. It was the custom of the Ishmaelites to wear gold earrings. They answered, We'll be glad to give them. So they spread out a garment, and each of them threw a ring from his plunder onto it. The weight of the gold rings he asked for came to 700 shekels, not counting the ornaments, pendants, the purple garments worn by the king of Midian, or the chain that were on the necks of the camels. Gideon made the gold into an ephod, which he placed in Ophrah, his town. All Israel prostituted themselves by worshiping it there, and it became a snare to Gideon and his family. No sooner had Gideon died than the Israelites again prostituted themselves to the Baals. They set up Baal Berith as their god and did not remember the Lord their God, who had rescued them from the hands of their enemies on every side. They also failed to show any loyalty to the family of Jerubbaal, that is Gideon, in spite of all the good things that he had done for them. Praise be to God. This story is about Gideon today.
Kulina Gideon man mukhanu nifoltoina. Goita azmorotso hayal tawagay kam zmona bered kulina nifeltina.
So we all know the story of Gideon. He was a chosen warrior by God himself.
Is it so why is he celestemiti watadarat geru ne mitin salasan hamushen shih sarawit zsa'are sobayu.
So Gideon was the original 300 men who killed 135,000 people.
Is it malet the nafs wakaf nay Gideon watader 450 taqarant nero mom maletu.
So if we think about the ratio, we're talking about one warrior to every 450 people.
سلازي بتعمل نتصوريو انت حيل كاخلت السلاس تغطى ودق تغل 450 سبز ودق سبقنا يلن.
So the story is clear. So even if you were really powerful, you can probably take two or three men, but you cannot take 450 men alone.
ንጹሪት ታሪክ እግዚአብሔር ካኹም ይኸው እንደሊዎ ብጀካ ንስስ ማንንም ሰብ ከገብሩ ኸም ዘይከል ከፍልጦም ይደል ነይሩ.
So the story is clear. God wanted to make it known that he is the only one that could have made this possible.
ስለዚ እዚ ሁሉ ሐሊፉ አበ ንሚዲያናን ወቂዑ አብስዕረት ምዝበጽሐ ዘሎ ፈተናይሲ ተወዲዩ አብዝብለሉ ዝነበረ ኢና ተታሪክ ክንሪዮ.
So after his army killed the mighty army of 135,000, we see that it was by God's hand, but he thought even though the war ended, his problems were just beginning.
ነቲ ካብ ጸላቱ ብደገ ዝመጽእ ዝነበረ ስዒርዎ እዩ ኣብ ውሽጢ ዝተላዕለ ፈተና ግና ንርአዮ.
So he was able to take on the army from the outside, but he had his own battles from the inside.
ሓደ ነገር ክነግረኩም ኣብ ወዳድኣ ግዕዞና ብጣዕሚ ከምቲ ኣጃምራና ኣገዳሲ እዩ.
So let me tell you this, the end of our story is also as important as the beginning.
ብጽቡቕ ጀሚርካ እንድሕር ከምኡ ጌርካ ዘይወደኻዮ ጉዕዞኻ ኪድናብ ክኸውን ይኽእል እዩ.
So if you begin your journey but you don't continue in the same way, it can end also badly.
እዚ ነገር እዚ ፈጺሙ ከምቲ ዝደለኻዮ ኸይኮነ ንህይወትካ እውን ኮስቲ ዝገብረካ ነገር ክኸውን ይኽእል እዩ.
So somewhere along the journey, if we don't continue the way we began, we can cost ourselves majorly at the end.
ብዛዕባ ዴማስ ጳውሎስ ከም ዝተዛረበ ሰሚዕና ኣለና ኣብ ሰለስተ ክፋል እዩ ዴማስ ዘሎ ኣብ መፅሓፍ ቅዱስ ከምዚ ድማ ኢሉ ኣሎ ኣብ ቆሎሴ ብዛዕባ ዴማስ ክዛረብ ከሎ ኣብ ራብዓይ ምዕራፍ ከምዚ ኢሉ ጳውሎስ ሉቃስ እቲ ፍቁር ሓኪምን ዴማስን ሰላም ይብልኹም ኣለዉ.
So we know about Demas's story, and he's mentioned three times in the New Testament. In Colossians, we're told, our dear friend Luke and the doctor and Demas send greetings.
መሊሱ ኣብ ፊልሞን ከምዚ ኢሉ ኣሎ ብዛዕባ ዴማስ ከምኡውን እቶም መታዓይተይ ማርቆስን ኣርስቶኮስን ዴማስን ሉቃስን ሰላም ይብሉካ ኣለዉ.
And again it is said about Demas in Philemon chapter 1, and so do Mark, Aristarchus, Demas and Luke, my fellow workers.
ታቃለ ደልያ ዘለኹ ባ መታዓይተይ ዝብላ ዘሎ እዩ.
So what I'm trying to take from this verse is where Paul calls Demas my fellow worker.
ስለዚ ክሳብ ክንድዎ ኣገዳሲ ሰብ እዩ ነይሩ ዴማስ ኣብ ህይወት ናይ ጳውሎስ.
So Demas was a very important person to Paul.
እቲ ዝሕዝን ግና ኣብ ጢሞቴዎስ ካልኣይ ጢሞቴዎስ ከምዚ ኢሉ ኣሎ ብዛዕባ ዴማስ.
But it is also said something else about him in 2 Timothy about Demas.
ቁጥር 10 እንደዳሪና ደማስ ነዛ ዓለም እዚኣ ፈትይዋ እዩ እሞ ሓዲጉኒ ናብ ተሰሎንቄ ከደ.
Paul said about Demas in 2 Timothy, for Demas, because he loved this world, has deserted me and has gone into Thessalonica. The end is just as important as our beginning.
ብዙሓት ጀሚሮም ኣብ መገዲ እንዳተረፉ ይኸድዮም እንድሕር ስጋዕ መጨረሽታ ጉዕዞኻ ዘይተ ዘይርኢኻዮ ግና ዝመጸኻዮ ኩሉ ከንቱ ክኸውን ይኽእል እዩ ኣሕዋተይ.
So there's a lot of people who start off really well, but they ruin the ending. So for many of us, we just have to be careful to make sure we watch our lives along the way.
ስለዚ ንጊዴዎን ዘገጠሞ ፈተናታት ክንርዮ ኢና ብኽልተ መልክዕዩ ጸላ ይፈቲንዎ መጀመርያ ኣብ ማሕበራዊ ናብሩ ድሓር ድማ ኣብቲ መንፈሳዊ ህይወቱ.
So we're going to see the two types of temptations that Gideon underwent. The first one is his social life, and the second one is the temptations in his spiritual life.
ፈተና ኣብቲ ማሕበራዊ ናብሩ ንረይ.
First we're going to see the temptations in his social life.
ብደቂ እስራኤል ግሩም ዝኾነ ጠለብ ይቐርበሉ ቁፅሪ 22 እንተዳሪናዮ ከምዚ ይብል ሽዑ ኣብ እስራኤል ንጊዶን ካብ ኢድ ሚድያናውያን ኣድሒንካና ኢኻ እሞ ንስኻን ወድኻን ወዲ ወድኻን ግዝኡና በልዎ.
The first temptation we see in verse 22, it became from a request. The people requested for him to rule over them, and they said, rule over us, you and your sons and your grandsons, because you have saved us from the hand of the Midian. What I want everyone to see here is who's the one that rescued these people. So who's really the one that rescued these people when he helped them to win the victory with 300 men against 135,000 people? The story should be clear that it was God. But why are they saying this? Why do they want him to be king? People from just our nature, we want three things. So there's three things that we naturally want as people. And we as Eritreans, we know the first one is peace. We all want peace. The second thing we all want is security. And the third thing that we all want is prosperity. So every country wants peace in order to function.
And
when we look at the New Testament, even in the story of Jesus, we see that the Israelites wanted him to be king over them. In Luke chapter 24, we read this. It says, but we had hoped that he was the one who was going to redeem Israel. So everyone who, someone who does good for you is the one you want to rule over you. So we also see this in John chapter 6, verse 15. Even after he had fed them and taught them, it says that they tried to make him king by force, and he withdrew again from the mountains by himself to get away from them. Did you guys hear that? So they try to force him to be king over them. So the first reason we talked about was that the people wanted peace, prosperity, and also the security from having the king. But there's also a second reason. The second reason we find it in 1 Samuel chapter 8, verse 19. So 1 Samuel chapter 8 verse 19 says, but the people refused to listen to Samuel. No, they said, we want a king over us. Then we will be like the other nations with a king to lead us and to go out before us and fight our battles. So this tells us that they really wanted one thing, which was to be like the rest of the other nations surrounding them.
ካብ እግዚአብሔር ከገዛካ ሰብ ከገዛካ እንታይ አይነት ክሳ ክንደይ ድኹም እዩ አእምሮና ኣሕዋተየ.
So instead of God ruling over them, for them to desire people to rule over them, that's the weak way of thinking.
እቲ ጽቡቕ ነገር ግና ጸቕጢ ንግድዮን ኣየሰነፎን ንጉስና ኹን ወድኻ ሊትራሊ ንግስነት እዮም ሂቦሞ.
So, but all these things, even though they pressured him to try to be king over them, he did not give in or bend to the pressure.
ብዙሓት መንእስያት ኣለኹም ኣብዚ.
There's a lot of young people here.
ምስዞም ደቀይ ክዛረብ ከለኹ ኩሉ ግዜ ዝሰምዖ ነገር ኣለኒ.
There are some things that I hear even when I speak to my own children.
እቶም ሰባት ግን ከምኦም ዝገብሩ ዘለዉ ዝብል ኣዘራርባ ኣሎ.
I hear them say that they're talking about other people doing the same thing that they want to do.
نستوعل كل جزيه ماجوريتي يقنع يكونن.
The majority is not always correct.
اتي سقلو دمو ابدقنا ابانا نبدقنا يكون زبل ماجوريتي بروحات.
When they said crucify him, let his blood be on our heads, that was the majority speaking to Jesus.
كل جزيه زعبه دمص سله زلو سنسو حق حيزلو مالت ايكونن.
Just because it carries the loudest voice doesn't mean it's the correct voice.
ስለዚ እዝና ንክስነት ጠለብ ግዲዮን ከመን ሙሃኒ ፈልጥ ገዛሩሱ ይፈልጥ ስለዚ ነበረ ጸግ ከብሎ ኸሎ ንሪ.
So this request to try to make Gideon the king over them, it was not from him, and he knew himself, so that's why he didn't want it.
ካላይ ፈተና እዚቲ ናይ ማሕበራዊ ናብራ ፈተኑ እዩ ነይሩ ካላይ ግና ባላ ክትርእዋ ዝደለየኩም መንፈሳዊ ፈተና ነይራቶ.
So that was the first temptation, just dealing with the social aspect of things, but also there was a spiritual temptation that he was dealing with.
ኣብ ቁጥሪ 24 እንተዳሪናዮ እቲ ጽሑፍ ከምዚ ይብል.
If we go back to verse 24, this is what it says.
ንግዲዮን ድማ ኸባሃትኩም ግዳ ሓደ ልማኖ ልምን ኣለኹ ነፍሲ ወከፍ እቲ ዝማረኾ ቀለባት ሃቡኒ በሎም.
And he said, I do have one request, that each of you give me an earring from your share of plunder.
ንሳቶም ንግስነት ይሓትዎ ኣለዉ ንሱኻ ማቴርያል ልምን ኣሎ ብሩኻት.
So they're asking him to be king over them, and he's asking them to give him material things.
ንምንታይ ደልይዎ እዚ ማቴርያል እዚ?
So why did he want this material possessions?
ምላሾም ንርአ ቁፅሪ 25 26 ንሳቶም ከዓ ተሓጒስና ንበካ በሉ.
So let's look at the reason, verse 25 and 26, and they answered, we'll be glad to give them to you.
ክዳን ድማ ዘርግሑ ነፍሲ ወከፍ ከዓ ነቲ ዝማረኾ ቀለባብቲ ናብኡ ደርበዩ.
So they spread out a garment, and each of them threw a ring from this plunder onto it.
እንተሪኦሞም እዞም ሰባት እዚኦም ከይተዋላወሉ 700 ሲቃል እንታይ ማለት ይመስልኩም? 700 ሲቃል 57 ፓውንድ ዝኸውን ወርቂ ሂቦም.
So this is how much it weighed. It says in all it's about 57 pounds of gold that they laid down before him.
እዚ ውጽኢቱ ንርአዮ እንታይ ከም ዘምፀ.
So let's look at the cost that this brought about.
ግድዮን ይብል እቲ ጽሑፍ ኣኪቡ ነቲ ዝተዋህቦ ዝተማረኸ ወርቂ ኤፎድ ሰሪሕዎ ይብል ኣሎ እቲ ጽሑፍ.
So Gideon took all the gold that they had given him, and he turned it into an ephod.
ኤፎድ እንታይ ማለት ምዃኑ እንድሕሪናዮ እቲ ሊቀ ካህናት ዝኽደኖ ካባ እዩ.
So if we look at what the meaning of an ephod is, it's the robe of the high priest.
እዚ ዝኽደንዎ ምንም ጅጋ ይብሉን ኣብ ላዕሊ ንገብሮ ከምዚ ተመሳሳሊ ናይ መልሲ ንገብሮ ናይ መርዓ ማለት እዩ.
So you can compare it to the robe that some people wear at the wedding for their reception. And of course, but this is made of gold. So he took what he had made, this ephod, and he set it up in Ophrah, which was his town. But this was the gold that was taken in plunder from the Midian battle.
ሐደ ነገር አለ ንግዚአብሔር መንፈሳው ነገር እንዲናንዛረብ ደለና ንግዚአብሔር በዚህ ነገር ዘከተገልግሎ ይተከልኛ ሐንካስን ዝተዘምተን ንግዚአብሔር አይከውኒ.
So there's two things that we can't present as sacrifices to the Lord, things that are lame or stolen.
ንግዚአብሔር በስውርን ቅጥቅጥን ልብ ትራሃ ተመስክኖ ተክብሮ ትክል.
So you can only worship God with a broken and contrite heart.
እትሕቶ ንምንታይ እዩ ጊዲዮን ከምኡ ገይሩ?
So the question is, why did Gideon do this?
ስለምንታይ ከምዚ ገበረ እቲ ጽሑፍ ኣይዛረብን?
So the word of God doesn't give us the reasons why he did it.
ኣጸቢኦ ግን ግምት ኣለና ስለምንታይ ከምዚ ገበረ?
But we can take some guesses as to why he did it.
ንግስነት ኣይተቀበለን.
He didn't accept the kingdom, the king's role.
ሐደ ነገር ግና ንሩሱ ዝሐዘ ይመስል.
But there was something that he still kept to himself.
እዚ ሰብ እዚ ጎይታ ገጽ ንገጽ ራየ ሰብ ይነሩ.
This was a person who had literally seen God face to face.
እዚ ሁሉ አወት ካበምጸ ምስ እግዚአብሔር ካብ ተዛረበ ናይ ክህንነት ቦታ ዝደለየ ይመስል.
Oh, this seemed like the person who wanted the place of a high priest.
እቲ ቃል ይብለና ግና እቲ ኤፎድ
But the word tells us that this ephod became a snare to Gideon and his family.
Literally trap.
So it literally became a trap to him.
Hade malakhti kullna khabzu khnwasid idallahu salasta hasab nabra say malzneru zmalakhti zghadal khullahu.
So there's three thoughts that I want to share with you based on this reading.
በጀሃድኩ ካለተ ደሰማሁም ማአድ መንስያት አለኹ ምዝ ነገር እዚ ስምዑኒ.
So if you haven't heard anything yet, all the young ones, please listen to these points.
ቁጥር 1.
Number 1.
ዝኾነ ነገር ናባኹም አቢሉኹ መርሕ ኮሎ እዚ ነገር እዚ ብኸመይ ንህወተይ ጸልዎ ኢልኩም ሕተቱ.
So when anything comes into your life, first question you should ask yourself is, how is this going to affect my life? Because when someone begins to go towards something, it's easier to go downwards than to try to come back up. So I have to ask, how is this going to affect my life as a whole?
ቁጥር 2.
Number 2.
ንሕዋተይ በዚ ሃንጾም ዴ?
Will this edify my brothers and sisters?
ብዝገበርካዮ ነጠንጠንሲ ንሕዋትካ ናብ እግዚአብሔር ከተቕብሮዎም ክኸውን ኣለዎ ስራሕካ እዚስ ኣለዎ ድዩ ዝገብሮ ዘለኹ ክንብል ክንክእል ኣለና.
So no matter what you get yourself into, you have to be able to ask yourself, will this help to build and edify my other brothers and sisters in Christ? The third point is actually the most important of these. So So no matter what I do or get myself into, will this honor God? We have to ask, will this honor God in some way?
Gideon shedded bololu mzhullu jignenatu abzi neru ni egziaber yakhbir diu ziz gobro zallahu ilu ay hatatan imassil.
So Gideon, after he had done all these amazing things, this is where he lost his footing. He didn't ask, will this honor God in some way?
Waganize neger zin rayo brohan.
So let's look at the cost of these things.
Bahansab na Gideon celeste neger khod kholo khab unre.
So we see that it cost Gideon three specific things. So the witness that he had, his witness was broken.
نبعل بريت أملاهم جبروا دك إسرائيل نتي خبيت توم أبزريو زنبرو خلهم صلاتهم زرحنهم إخيار أملاهم أيذكرون نبيت ربعل ملئت جديون زيان حزة بروحات كتر سلاسان حمشين نسوا أيزي كمتين السون إسرائيل جبروا لهم كل تبون أجرسي قلهم وياكوا أي جبروا لديب.
So let's read verse 33. No sooner had Gideon died than the Israelites began prostituting themselves to Baals. They set up Baal-berith as their god and did not remember the Lord their God, who had rescued them from the hands of their enemies on every side. They also failed to show any loyalty to the family of Jerubbaal, that is Gideon's family, in spite of all the good things that he had done for them. If we look at this, the story of Gideon.
It
seems like his whole life he had honored God, but right at the end, he seemed like he ran into trouble.
ምስክርነቱ ከመዘለው አብቲ ከተማ ዝነበሮ ነገር ከጠፍ ሆሎ ክርሳዕ ሆሎ ማን መሃኑ ኳሳዕ ዘይዝክርዎ ኾን ኮሎ ንሪ.
So we see that his testimony and his witness to the people that he had so long led, it was ruined at the end.
እቲ አብቲ ህዝብ ዝነበሮ ጽልዋ ማለት ናብ እግዚአብሔር ንኸቅርቦም ዝነበሮ ኃይሊ ከም ዘለዎ ስለዝጠፈስ ፈጺሞም ናብ ማለኽቲ ይኸዱ ይብለና ትጽሑፍ.
So everything that he had done to try to lead them to the Lord, it seemed like his entire witness was stripped away. His witness, his testimony was broken.
Say that again.
And even his family as well was forgotten. So in conclusion, I would like to say this. So in conclusion, everything that you had worked to build and to raise up, when it falls apart, it's a very sad thing to see.
ሓደ ነገር ግን ክንሓስብ ይደሊ ኣለኹ.
But I would like for us to think about one thing.
ኣብ ንገብሮ ኩሉ ነገርና ንእግዚኣብሔር ከነቐድም ይደሊ ኣለኹ ብሩሃል.
In everything that we do, we need to be able to put God first before us.
እግዚኣብሔር ዘቐደመ ዘበለ ተሪፉ ኣይፈልጥን እዩ.
Anyone who puts God first has never failed.
እግዚአብሔር ቀቅድሚው ዝወጸ ደሳዒሩ አይፈልጥን እዩ.
Anyone who puts the Lord first is not beaten.
እዚ ናምልኾ ኣምላኽ ብሩኻት ስጋዕ ናብቲ ካሌጅ ትበፅሖ ኣይኮነን.
So it's not about the higher education, but we need to be able to put God first. So we need to be able to honor God our entire life. So please stand with me as we go to God in prayer.
ሐረ ትጽቢት አለው እግዚአብሔር አብዘበና ብሩኻት አብዘበንካ አኽብርካ ያኽትሐልፍ እግዚአብሔር አባኻ ትጽቢት አለው.
There's one thing that the Lord wants from us, and that's to put and honor him with our generation.
አብዘበና ሁሉን እግዚአብሔር ክብሪ ህብና ያኽንሐልፍ ይጽበና እግዚአብሔር.
So to glorify him during our lifetime here and our generation.
እስኪ ንጸልይ ብሩኻት.
Let us pray.
እግዚአብሔር አምላክ ክብሪ ንበካሎና አብዘበን ሁሉ ንዓኻ አኽቢርና ክንሓልፍ እግዚአብሔር አምላክ ስጋዕ እዚ ዘይኮነ ስጋዕ መጨረሽታ እግዚአብሔር ጉያ ይወድየ ክንብል ክንክል እግዚአብሔር አብዘበና ንዓኻ ተገዚእና ክንሓልፍ ጸጋ ብዝሓልና እስከ ኣሕዋተየ ኩልና ገዛእ ርእስና ንእግዚአብሔር ነረክቦ نفسه وقفنا كوميتمنت خدلينا نجزيابير بمستوى عليها خدك الزوء تخل بزفكت ازخودو هاي ما نتاوي انترحيو نعم لخصبات ابزبونهم كتر معالتهم فليتهم يمزحلفو بروها
Father God, we come to you this morning, Lord, just presenting ourselves to you individually. Father, we see the story of Gideon this morning, and we know that it's not just how we start, Lord, but it's how we carry our lives and how we finish as well that matters, Lord. And Father, we just pray for everyone here, all the young ones, no matter where they are at this moment in their lives, Lord, that they would come to you, first of all, to make you king and Lord over their lives. To put you first. And Father, no matter what challenges or struggles that they may have, whether in school, their social life, their spiritual life, Father, we just pray that they can keep you first and not look to anyone else, Lord. Not to look to others to say that everyone else is doing this or the crowd is going this way, Lord, but to stand and to say, we are going to stand with the Lord. We will stand for the things He stands for and against the things that He's against, Lord. Father, we just pray that everyone here, Lord, would make that commitment, that no matter the obstacle, the challenge, the temptation, Lord, when the things seem good and pleasing, Lord, that we would ask, does it honor you first? And is this gonna hinder our brothers and sisters or build them up? So whatever it is that you present before us, anything that might come before us, Lord, we just pray that we would look to honor you with our lives in this generation and in all the decisions that we make, Father. And we just give everything over to you this morning, Lord. Amen.
Thank you, guys. Couple. God bless you, Brother Baker. حاونا زلين ابزي كمصيمه